about to Hajar al-Aswad criticizing. This is they say this is stone. Why people are Muslim people? Islam is rejecting the, you know, the things, material object. This kind of some people is kissing or.
I know what you're talking about. The black
bidat,
stone.
Is that bidat? Is that strong hadith?
Yeah, it's a strong hadith, and we don't worship stones as they claim because we don't worship these stones, and we don't worship any stone. The black stone, black Hajar al-Aswad, is from Jannah. And Nabi kissed it because it's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khalas. Now we know, sometimes to show respect to your mother, you kiss her head. No one thinks you worship your mother's head, except a Christian. But Christian, Ameen, Ameen, Barakallahu Fikum. Except a Christian, but you know, Muslims, you have to understand, ayyuha al-Muslimun. If Christian criticize Islam, you should be proud. He said that true Islam is the truth. Why? How on earth your mind has the capacity to accept God become a baby and someone was breastfeeding him, taking care of him? If your mind accept that, you should not be speaking about nothing. Your mind need what? You need to be deconstructed again. Rehabilitated. So you have to understand that when a Christian comes to say, wait. Just let me make it clear to people. This man, he believes God become a baby, someone changed his nappy, and he was hitting him at the back, stop burping. That's the God he believes in. Someone take care of him. But God is not in need of nothing. So if this guy is like that, can he speak? He cannot speak. Fahimt? So now, kissing the black stone, Umar al-Khattab clarified it already. He said, Wallah, I know you do not harm or benefit independently. What does that mean? That is not going to harm us or benefit us. But how is, if you kiss it, you get a reward. And that's mean you worship it. Likewise, when I kiss my mother's head, as out of respect, I get a reward. Doesn't mean that my mother's head, I worship my mother's head, it's going to enter me Jannah. You see? So, alhamdulillah, Islam is clear. But these Christians, every Sunday they come with a new shubha. Because why then? They should reflect. How come we've been coming to the park for nearly 10 years? And every time we bring a doubt, our doubt, it gets refuted. They should reflect. But because they're stubborn, they hate Islam, you know, they don't, they,
أخي, I and never, they know they are true. They know the Islam.
Wallahi, they know that. Wallahi, الذي لا إله غيره ولا رب سواه. They know the truth. They know it's the haq. But they're looking for an excuse. They worship a baby. Alhamdulillah, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is Allah? قل هو الله أحد. Say Allah is one. Allah is samad. Self-sufficient. Everything is in need of him. He's not in need of nothing. لم يلد ولم يولد. He begat not. Neither was he begotten. ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. And there's nothing comparable to him. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Who is Allah? Al-Hayyu Al-Qayyum. That's why they say all of Allah's attributes and names, it goes back to Al-Hayy and Al-Qayyum. He's Al-Hayy, ever-living Qayyum, who's in charge of everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala, who takes care of everything. Just look how Allah describes himself in the Quran. Now you come to Christianity. God is powerful, but he becomes weak. He becomes a baby. Someone should just not be. But God, he takes care of everything. But someone was taking care of him. God is not in need of nothing, but he was in need of his mother's milk. I mean, akhi, how is it? Barakallahu fik. Alhamdulillah, Allah saved us from Christianity and from nonsensical beliefs. Alhamdulillah for Islam. If you have any questions, you are more than welcome. Doesn't mean I'm a scholar, yeah? Alaykum salam, akhi. How are you, brother? Kayfak, tayyib?
Alhamdulillah.
Bagheer, barakallahu fik.
Shamsi, I have a question. What do you sponsor people who accuse us of irja for saying, for basically, they say that if a ruler doesn't like 100% by Quran and Sunnah that he's a kafir? How do you respond that? We say no, that's incorrect, but they accuse us of irja. They say that we're kafir, irja. They accuse us of all sorts of things.
Because we say the ruler is a...
We say that he's a Muslim even if he's not ruling.
By Sharia?
Yeah.
Yeah, because why? We don't call a Muslim leader kafir, except there is if he is for that da'wah. So is that. Except if he becomes, what they call it, if he say Sharia Islamiyah is out of date, or he changed the whole, some ulama said that the fact he changed the whole everything, that is the fact that he believes is not valid. But I don't know, according to my knowledge, no, in Algeria, there's no Sharia there, but there is some Sharia in some aspects of life. So Sharia has not been removed completely. In Algeria, if the police catch you with a girlfriend, they will arrest you. Yeah. I remember once I was in the seaside and they catch one guy, they arrest him and they took him to prison. You know, not prison, they took him to the police station. So, or you drink alcohol, they will arrest you. You know? So, the may Allah guide them, but we know Murji, alhamdulillah. Because Irja, as Imam Al-Barbahari said, anyone that believes iman of the iman is a belief of the heart and speech of the tongue and action of the limbs increases with Allah's obedience and decreases with Allah's disobedience, then he's not a murji, he has left irja. But it's the way of the Khawarij to scare people away. They say he's a murji. How murji? Are you murji with the leader? Because I don't call him kafir, that's why I'm murji. You khariji, that's why you want me to call him murji, you know. So alhamdulillah, and we don't know defend the leaders that that do oppressions. We are free from the oppressions. But there's difference between saying no rebel because it's going to cause greater harm and to defend the oppressions. We don't defend the oppressions, alhamdulillah. You know, and the mushkila of our time, we've been focusing too much on the leaders.
But no learning.
And no learning, barakallahu fiqh, you know, akhi. I mean,
if you see the schoolers, only few people coming to learn it. And if you go to the, like some place to enjoy, so many people.
Akhi.
And they say, it's
kafir. The schoolers.
Like this one, the Kurdish one. Have you seen them? They say, Kurdish, we need free, we need the woman, this. And same time, they accuse the woman.
Yeah, mutanaqidun, akhi. But you know, what is it? What we say to you, akhi? What we have to do, focus on ourselves, you know, focus on our tazkiyat al-nafs, purifying our souls. You know, wallahi, these guys who talk about leaders, like one of the, some of them don't even pray.
Yes.
Yeah, you don't pray. You know, subhanAllah, yeah, focus on yourself, ya akhi. Okay, like, okay, this leader is kafir billah wal yawm al-akhir, is worse than Fir'aun. But now, okay, what is next? He's a Christian, Jesus love you. Okay, what is next? There's nothing next. Khawar is a Christian, you know, in this specific thing. The least are kuffar, kuffar tawaghis. Okay, what is next now? What should I do? I used to know some of them in West London. Every day nasheed. Every day is nasheed.
No
pillars of prayer, no conditions of prayer. It's nasheed day and night. Barakallahu feekum. So alhamdulillah. But now, you remember this Anjum Chowdhury has been released. And now he's allowed to speak. Anjum Chowdhury is a person of misguidance, deviations. He never studied in his life. He was a lawyer, become a liar. You know? How this person talks about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, unbelievable. But you know, this country, sometimes the law is crazy here. How are you going to allow this person to speak again? When you know, except if you know that he made tawbah, he repents, he changed. And the khawarij will change. But they do change. When I say they change, doesn't mean that some of them change completely. But they change like chameleons. They change according to their country. If they see the country, the government coming after them, they change, become like, you know, we love everyone, it's all loving, you know?
You remember 10 years ago, one of them from Yemen, he said, I will leave the Khawarij. The president of Saudi, they say, come back, okay, we will give you house, we will give you everything. When he go back, he pleads himself.
Yeah,
he
exploded himself. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, sahih. You know, these people, akhillah al-musta'an, they focus on issues which does not benefit the ummah. You know, they've been around for a long time. What is that was dead? You know, just going out protesting Sharia. I mean, we love Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sharia is the best way of life. But Sharia, this term, has been misused and been misunderstood and misimplemented. Meaning, Sharia is a comprehensive term. Looking at worshipping Allah alone from Sharia. Right? Looking after your parents, Sharia. But to come to this country, either you're a refugee or your parents came as a refugee. Or even your parents came over here, they give them visa, then they give them passport. You are a person here, you have a contract with them. You understand? And it looks bad on a Muslim. Like, you know, for example, in Syria, what happened? They welcomed many Syrians to come to this country. Then you have a Syrian, for example, say, listen, I'm taking over the country. They think, well, these crazy people. He's like me, allowing you to come to my house, helping you. Then you say, I'm going to take over your house. And I think this guy's Majnoon. But the best way to do what we do, alhamdulillah, show them that the best thing for them in this country and around the world is Islam. Do it with a good way, respectful way, that we want good for them. You know, if they take care of us and take care of our families, we say we want to, reward you for that. You understand? Be wise, subhanAllah. But no, come into a country, tomorrow they can send you back easily. And you say, I'm going to establish Sharia and the parliament. That's not the teaching of Islam. When the Prophet Muhammad sent Sahaba to Habasha, they are coming out protesting Sharia. Barakallahu feekum. These people are, and I believe, wallahi, there's many indication. I believe they work for the enemies of Allah, these guys. Not all of them, some of them being misguided, misnakeen. But I believe they are set up to make Islam look bad. Especially now, see how many people accept Islam, especially famous people. So you have to connect the dots. Now many people are accepting Islam. The next minute we have Andrew Charles are speaking. Okay, why? Because this guy, they need him now. Andrew Chaudhry is the best person to use to make Islam look bad. To wallahi, yaqi, the enemies of Islam, they love him. The media, do you remember the media? They always invite him. Even though they know he says crazy things. And they know this person is not a scholar. I spoke to him outside in my area, face to face. He's an ignorant person. Yet he's speaking on behalf of the Ummah of Muhammad alayhi salam. Because he was the enemies of Allah, they want to scare the English people about Islam. The best person to use is Ajam Chowdhury. To scare the Englishman for Islam. You know? Alhamdulillah, teach. They give you a freedom to give da'wah, utilize it, and appreciate that. You know? Doesn't mean you agree with everything they say or they do. But I'm going to utilize this opportunity to give da'wah to non-Muslims. And us doing that, alhamdulillah, you see many people accepting Islam. Alhamdulillah. Barakallah feekum. Anyway, I need to rest a bit. I have a class at 7 o'clock. Yeah.